Okay, now we're sewing the legs on, and they're pretty simple. You just sew the flap part, this flap, to the bottom of the bear, and I sew them pretty close to the front. Okay, so I've already got one on, so we're just going to take the one corner might overlap the other one in the front of the bear. Just want to make sure that when your bear sits down, that the hearts are going to be upward. Then you just want to pin them in place. Okay, so once you have them pinned in place, you can see this one corner is overlapping that one a little bit. On yours, you can put them as wide apart as you want. I just like them a little bit closer together. So I'm going to sew whip stitch this one edge to the body. Because I've overlapped this one corner, it's going to be a little bit too thick there. So I'm just going to head over to this corner over here. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to sew went down into the body and back up. And again, down into the body and back up. Okay, I'm just gonna go inside there. Okay, that edge is now sewn down. You can see how far that flaps down and this one doesn't. See the difference there? So I'll just run a set of stitches along this here. Go in. I'm gonna come up on the other side. Okay, so that looks pretty good. So when the bear sits down, you can see the hearts will be sitting upward and in front. So I'll just knot this off. So I'll bring the yarn needle through that loop, pull it tight. Now that's knotted off, so I'm just going to bring the yarn tail now down into the body. Okay, pull on it slightly and cut. Okay, now we're sewing the arms on. And you can see I sewed the top of the arm one ring down below that neck. And you want the arms to go ahead and thread your yarn needle. I'm going to place it on the body and make sure I'm happy with how they're placed. So now I'm just going to whip stitch the top of this arm to this ring right here. Going back into the body and immediately back up and through the top edge of the arm. Into the body and immediately back up to the edge of the arm. So that's all there is to that. Now that top edge is sewn to the body. So what I'll do is I'll just put a stitch here on this one side and one on this side just to hold the arm down. I'm going to go into the body, coming up on the other side. Okay, I'm right there. So I'm just going to go on the edge of this arm, just catching the edge of this arm and bring the needle down into the body and onto the other side. So you can see that just kind of stitches the arm down so it's not flaring outward. Okay, and I think that's about it. So I'll bring this yarn tail now where this other one is coming out of. I'll knot these two off. I'll cut them up shorter. And then I'll just push that knot into the body. Okay, now we're sewing the ears in, and I pin them in place before I sew them in place. Placement is completely up to you. I like them to be in line with the arms. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a clip from a previous bear tutorial that I have here on YouTube, because the ears are sewn in the exact same way. So you can just follow along that clip and sew in the ears. Okay, now we're going to start sewing the ears on. Now you pin them in place before you start sewing either one of them in, and you want to make sure that you're happy with the placement and that they look great and all that good stuff. So you just pin down the corners like I've done here. Okay, I've already got the one sewn on, and I just brought the yarn tail out through a stitch hole. I'm going to leave it hanging and wait for the other one. So before you pin them on, what I like to do is make sure that the finishing yarn tail is on a corner. So if it's sitting like this, just reposition your ear until it's sitting out in the corner. And then you just flatten it out and pull on it, shape it out a little bit with your fingers. Yeah, it'll go on like that. Then we're just going to place it on. And put your needle in on a slant so that when you're sewing around, you don't catch the stem of the pin. And you can put more pins too if you need them. And again, you want to make sure that it's sitting exactly where you want it and that it's even with the other one. So we're just going to go right in the corner of the ear down into the head, and I'm going to come up right on this other corner here. And then I'm going to grab this edge here and go into the head and out somewhere on the back of the head. So go back in the same hole you just came out of and then come up just on the other side of that first stitch you just put in. And grab that edge of the ear and go back down and come up somewhere else away from that area. So this corner is now sewn in, so you can take that pin out and this pin here. And I'm just going to go along and I'm going to sew all this edge down. And I'll show you what I do here to make it look nice and neat. I'm going to come up right beside the edge of the ear. And now when I go back in, I'm just going to grab that loop, the outer loop. You can see I'm going to pick these off so you can see that more clearly. So when you look at the edge of the ear, there's two loops of the stitch there. Two loops. I'm just going to grab the outer loops of those stitches. So grab the outer loop. You don't have to do it this way. I just find it makes it look a bit neater. I used to do both loops, but now I'm just doing the outside loop. Go back in and out through the back of the head. Go back in. Come up right close, and if you can, just grab that outer loop on your way through. Back in, out to the back of the head. Now if anything's pulling in the back of the head here, just reach in and pull it back up with your needle. Okay, so that entire edge is now sewn in, so I'm not going to go on the other side now and do the front of the ear. And it's just going to be the same way I did this one here. Go in, grab that one loop of the stitch, back down, right close to the ear, and out through the front of the head. Okay, and just keep repeating these steps all the way to the other edge of the ear. Okay, both the ears are sewn in, and now I'm going to bring this yarn tail out where the other one is hanging. Knot them off. cut them up a bit shorter, and then push the knot into the back of the head. Okay, now we're gonna sew in the muzzle. Now I've just stuffed a little bit. You don't need to worry about stuffing it too much because we can always stuff more after we get it partially sewn to the face. So I'll just put a little bit in there. You might want to just leave the stuffing out of yours for now. It's a little bit awkward. Now in the written pattern I say put the muzzle on top of the 12th row, but it depends on what looks best on your bear. On this one, I think it'll look better just above the 13th row. So I'm going to count down from the rings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. So the top of the muzzle is just above the 13th row. So just make sure that your muzzle is completely centered in between those ears and that it looks good. And now you're going to pin it in place. Use lots of pins. I'm putting the pins in on a slant because I'm going to be sewing around the pins and I don't want the yarn needle be hitting the shaft of the pin. So go ahead and pin it in. Lots and lots of pins. The more pins, the better. Okay, there we go. You can see lots of pins. Now, more pins, the better because the muzzle tends to move around as you're sewing. So the more pins you put in, the better chances that muzzle is not going to be moving around anywhere. Okay, so I've threaded my yarn needle. Now I'm just going to go right into the head, right beside the muzzle, as close as to the muzzle as I can get it. I'm going to bring the yarn needle down and up through a stitch hole away from that muzzle. Okay, going to go back in the same stitch hole I just came out of. And I'm going to go and put a stitch in the top. So I'm coming up just above the top of the muzzle, as close to the muzzle as I can get it. Okay, I'm going to go back in. I'm just going to catch the top of that muzzle. And I'm going to come out onto the side. Now I'm going to do these two sides. Going back in the same stitch hole I just came out of. Going to go down and come up just beside this muzzle as close as I can get it. Now catching this stitch right here. Going back into the head, down and away. That side, and that side stitch down. Now I'm just going to do this one. I'm back in the same stitch hole I was just in, coming up beside the muzzle, and then going right beside the muzzle and down into the head and away. You can see what I did there. I stitched the bottom, the top, and the two sides. Now I'm going to go in back through the same stitch hole I just came out of, and I'm just going to go around the muzzle. Always coming up as close as I can to the muzzle. Go back in. And come up where it's comfortable. You don't have to come right beside where you just came in. You can go back and forth, it doesn't matter. In. Okay, I think some of these pins can come out of here. Let's check how that muzzle looks. I could put pins back in if I need them. Okay, now that it's been mostly sewn in, I can take some stuffing if I need it. Take a little bit at a time. And I can see a gap right here. So I'm just going to put it right close to that gap. And I'll use my stuffing stick. And I'll push that stuffing into the muzzle. A back end of a pencil works great too, if you don't have a stuffing stick. Now I can use a stick, move that stuffing around as much as I need to. Okay, I think that's good. So now I'll just finish closing up these gaps. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. So there, all the gaps have been sewn closed. I'm just going to take this yarn. I'm going to wrap around a stitch post right there. Any stitch will do. Pull through that loop and pull tight. That just knotted it off. Now I'm going to take this yarn tail and just carry it away into the face, pull on it slightly, and cut. Okay, now we're going to sew the tail in. We do stuff the tail and you pin it in place. And again, I'm going to insert a clip from that previous bear tutorial because the tail is sewn in the exact same way. Okay, now we're going to put the tail on. And the tail does get stuffed. Now, if it's too hard to stuff it now, you can partially sew it to the body and then push the stuffing in there with a pencil after. I'm just going to put it on there. I'm going to put lots of pins in here. I'm pushing them in and down on a slant so when I sew around, I can sew around, leave the pins in there, and I won't hit the stem of the pin. It's just going in on a slant. Okay, and that's lots of pins, and that just holds it in place for me, and it won't move around as I'm sewing around the tail. So I'm just going to bring my yarn needle in as close to the tail edge as I can get it, and then come up somewhere else that's comfortable for the needle to come through. Make sure you're coming through a stitch hole. You're going to go back in the same hole you just came out of. I'm going to go over here on this side. Come up as close as I can to the tail, close to the edge as I can. Okay, I'm going to go back in, catching the bottom stitches of that tail. And I'll come up on this side now. And don't pull it so tight, you see it's altering the shape of the tail there, so I'm just going to reach in there and pull it back out. So I just want it snug, I don't want to pull it all too tight. So I'm going to go back in, and then I'm going to come up on this side now. I forgot to show you, once you sew the tail partially on and you need to stuff it some more, then just look for a little gap or leave a little gap there. I forgot I was going to do this, so I don't have a very big gap. There's a one here. I'll just put the stuffing there, and then I'll use the back end of a pencil or a stuffing stick and just push it in there. And make sure that you get it evenly around. Just use your stick to shape the tail out. There we go. And then you can continue sewing around. Okay, once your tail is sewn all the way around, there's no gaps anywhere, then just bring the yarn tail up somewhere near the edge there. I'm just going to wrap around one of the stitches, go through that loop, and pull it tight. And that just knotted off that yarn tail. Now you just bring this into the body and bury the yarn tail. Pull on it slightly and cut. Alright, all that's left now is the eyes, and I'm going to show you two different methods. One is how to glue the eyes in, the safety eyes in, and one is how to add buttons. Now this is just a regular button. This will work for a solid button that has a hole in the back as well. If you have solid buttons, those will work. This one's already been put in, and you can see there's no yarn tails to be seen on the back. And it's securely on there, it's not going anywhere. I'll show you that in a minute. Now all my other videos, I've always used fabric tack or tacky glue, and that works well. The only problem is it can get onto your doll if you don't do it exactly how I show you. Now I found this new stuff here, and it's called Fabric Fusion, and it's in a pen. I mean, how cool is that? And you can get it right on the stem of the safety eye, and you don't have to worry about it going all over the place. Now this stuff works really well. I just watched a video on YouTube and the lady was using Fabric Fusion to add glass, metal, plastic beads to her fabric. And apparently this stuff holds it on, and you can even wash the thing after it's dried. Okay, so this one has been glued in already, and I'm going to show you how to do this one here. So what you want to do is you want to make sure that you're getting it on the stem. I get it all around the stem and all around the base of the stem. Now you don't want to put gobs and gobs and gobs because it will ooze out the sides, and you don't want to get this on your doll. Okay, and now we're just going to push it in there. And you can see some of that glue is going to be shoved right up to the behind the eye, and that's good. And I'm just going to push it in, and it's done. Now you're supposed to leave this for 2 to 4 hours. Let it dry for 2 to 4 hours before you start pulling on it. And if there's any glue on the outside of the eye, make sure you get that off. So I want to thread my yarn through the button, but my yarn needle won't fit through the buttonhole because it's just too small for the eye of the yarn needle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a regular sewing needle, and I've just made a little loop of thread. So I'm going to pull my yarn through that loop. And I've decided which side is going to be the front of my button. So I want to start through the back side. I'm going to crisscross through all these holes. So I'm going to come up through the back side, pull my yarn through, and then I'm going to go over one buttonhole and go back in. And then it comes through the back side again and back over on the remaining buttonhole. And there I've just crisscrossed all those buttonholes. So I can take this thread loop off. And now I'm going to thread my yarn needle. So I'm just going to bend over the yarn and push the bend through. Okay, and I already know that I want the button to go right about there. So I'm going to go through a stitch hole and bring the yarn needle through the back, through a stitch hole. Make sure you're coming through stitch holes. Go and thread the other one now. Now I'm going to go in, but I'm not going to go through the same hole that I have the other one going. I'm going to go one post over. And when I go out, I'm going to go through the same stitch hole that that other yarn tail is coming through. So in through a different stitch hole and out through the same stitch hole. Okay, so now I could knot these off, but what I want to do is I want to add a little drop of glue back there so those buttons will never come loose off the face of the bear. So I'm going to use my Fabric Fusion and put a couple drops of glue there. Now I could pull those yarn tails tight. So now we want to knot these yarn tails off in the back. I'm going to do 2 knots, and I'm pulling a little tight because it makes a little bit of an indent here. It's kind of cute. And now I'm going to thread both these yarn tails again. And I want to get rid of this knot back here. So I'm going to go back in the same hole that these thread tails are coming out of, and I'm going to go down and come out somewhere else. Now I'm going to pull on these thread tails. I'm going to pull quite hard so I can bring up the thread tails as far as they'll come, and then I'll snip. And now when they spring back in, they're gone. And they're completely hidden away. So there you go, button eyes. I think they're just as nice as the safety eyes. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Thanks so much for watching, and see you soon.